The English Electric Company were pioneers in the field of using electricity as a source of power for railway traction. For the first electrified main line in Great Britain, between Liverpool and Southport, was powered by Dick Kerr and Company, one of the four firms which amalgamated in 1919 to form English Electric. When the time came for the application of the diesel engine to rail traction, once again it was this company who were pioneers in designing and constructing diesel-electric locomotives for the railways of Great Britain. Since that time, English Electric has sent an ever-increasing number of diesel-electric and electric locomotives abroad, where they've continued to win for themselves a reputation for efficiency, reliability, and an unfailing ability to do the work for which they were designed. In 1947, number 10,000, the first express diesel locomotive for Great Britain, was produced. This was achieved by the combined resources of the English Electric Company and what was then the LMS Railway Company. In chromium, locomotive number 10,000 is an impressive sight as she moves slowly out of the shop for the first time. The men who for weeks have worked at her building are there to give her a send-off. After short preliminary trials, diesel-electric locomotive number 10,000 was run from Derby to London. The railwaymen, who all their lives have been used to the familiar tattoo of the exhaust of steam engines, stopped a while from their work as the black and silver, softly purring diesel streaked by. Is this, they thought, the shape of things to come? Romance still clings to the steam engine, but romance alone will not run the railways. New ideas, new methods, must be given the chance to succeed. At Euston, on the 17th of December, 1947, the new locomotive made its first public appearance. And so, with the entry into the railway service of locomotive number 10,000, a new page has been turned in the history of rail development in Britain. While the steam engine must remain for some considerable time the principal means of locomotion, it now has, in number 10,000, a new challenger. Since her trials, number 10,000 has operated on the arduous route between London and Derby, passing Luton, Bedford, Leicester, Loughborough. She's done two round trips a day, with a total of 512 miles, and the train hauled has varied from 9 to 12 coaches. Nowhere was she called on for her maximum effort, but speeds of well over 80 miles an hour can be attained. At Euston, a few months later, diesel-electric 10,000 is joined by its teammate, diesel-electric 10,001. Coupled together to form one single unit of 3,200 horsepower, they arouse more than a little curiosity in the eternal schoolboy which exists in most of us. And so they pull out of Euston Station, drawing that most illustrious of trains, the Royal Scot, accelerating powerfully and easily up the difficult gradient outside the station. Moving swiftly and surely through the pleasant English countryside on their way north to Scotland, these two long, sleek black giants, the joint products of the brains and craftsmanship of the English Electric Company and what now the London Midland region of British Railways, form one more visual proof that British electric achievement is unsurpassed anywhere in the world.